For a year, they've hosted candidates, held forums, and collected pledges.
I'm here to tell you today that we've reached unanimity.
All leading up to their decision 2 weeks before caucus date.
The family leaders and organization will not take sides in this caucus process.
No endorsement. But seconds later,
therefore, my personal endorsement.
The leaders of Iowa's conservative movement removed their podium placard and lapel pins to personally endorse Rick Santorum.
He meets and exceeds the biblical qualifications.
And he has been a stalwart and a soldier for the sanctity of human life and God's design for the family in one man, one woman marriage.
Why the fine line?
So at the level of principle, they want to say, I think they're committed to a broader agenda than any one particular candidate in any one particular election. That said, there's also a built-in safety net.
So they don't anger supporters backing other candidates. But it's too late for that.
I do regret that one erstwhile friend and culture warrior has threatened to, quote, burn Bob's body, drag it through the streets, and hang it from a bridge, unquote, if Bob doesn't endorse who that person wants him to endorse.
Santorum's campaign didn't mind that the endorsement came from a leader and not the family leader.
And here's the key. To many people in Iowa, Bob Vanderplaats is the family leader. And the family leader is Bob Vanderplaats.
But Hurley and Vanderplaats admit they wanted another choice.
I would have preferred to be here today endorsing a team.
A lot of our supporters said, boy, it would make it a lot easier if one candidate would join another candidate, or maybe two candidates join another candidate, so that we could coalesce.